Hello friends, myself Elia R. Chandane, Assistant Professor from Department of Electronics, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see the topic Digital Video Capture from the subject Audio-Video Engineering. So what are the learning outcomes? At the end of this topic, students are able to differentiate between different types of image formats. They can select appropriate audio and video systems for various applications, the problem in analog video capturing and reproduction, and how these are overcome in digital process. They can also understand the concept of digital video compression. So what is a video and what is the basic concept of a video? So video is an excellent tool for delivering multimedia. Video places has the highest performance of demand on computer and its memory and storage. Digital video nowadays has replaced analog as the method of choice for making and delivering video for multimedia. Digital video devices produce excellent finished products at a fraction of the cost of analog type. Digital video eliminates the image degradation. Analog to digital by using analog to digital video conversion. Many digital video sources exist, but getting these are having some difficulties. That is, we have to get the copyright. These are some time consuming video sources and are expensive one. So how video is captured? So this diagram explains how a video is captured. So this is the basically the blank magnetized tape. This is the soft iron core, which is cut at a center, which is having a gap. The video signals are given to these windings, and these acts as the input. As soon as the input is given, then the electromagnetic flux is generated. This flux travels through the head and then gets induced on the blank magnetized tape. This area generally denotes the information which is recorded on the magnetized tape. So what are the problems in analog video capturing and reproduction? Basic are the color blending of the image or the video, low clarity, high generation loss, difficulty to edit. Televisions which generally use composite input, these are having less colors, which are less impure and less accurate than the color combination which is generally used in computers, which consist of RGB component. The NTSC televisions has some limited color palette, hence they have restrictions against the luminance levels, that is the brightness level and the black levels. Interlace scanning process, which takes time, as first it scans out odd lines and then the even lines. How digital video is captured? The digital video is often used to capture content from movies and television to be used in multimedia. A video source which consists of video camera, VCR, TV or a video disc is connected to the computer card in a computer, and the video source is played. The analog signal is then sent over the video card and then it is converted into the digital one. Here the VCR plays the analog video file. It is then given to the video card for the capturing purpose. The PC then converts the signal into the digital one and we get a converted digital file. Digital video architecture, this generally uses two basic processes, that is encoding of the video, and the after encoding the video files are again playback for the analysis purpose. The architecture generally includes a player which recognizes the format of the file to be played. Digital video compression schemes are used for coding and decoding purpose, and a particular algorithms are used for compression and video delivery. Codec generally decodes the compressed video in real time for fast playback, and streaming audio and video starts playback as soon as the file is transferred to the user computers to sustain the playback. Digital video compression. This is done for recording the video on a single CD and transferring that data on the CD or to a computer. So let us say the sequence is of 25 frames per second. This is the video and it requires up to 25 MB of space. So this is done by the process. Here the codec, which has the input from the video, the codec generally codes and decodes the information, that is, it compresses the video and it again decompresses the video, and we get the final format of the file, which is .avg or .mpeg file. The CD-ROM transfer rate, which is to be calculated, or which nowadays which are used, are 1x generally denotes the 150 kbps of speed, 10x generally denotes 1.5 mbps of speed, and 100x generally denotes 15 mbps of speed. The 1x, 10x and 100x, generally these are written on the sticker of that particular CD. Types of digital video compression techniques. Generally these include two basic techniques, that is lossless and lossy. In lossless, generally it preserves the exact image throughout the compression and decompression process, whereas in lossy, it eliminates some of the data in the image and therefore provides greater compression ratios than the lossless compression. The lossy is again divided into two types, which includes the coding and decoding process. The first coding process and decoding process is the special type in the lossy, and the second one is the temporary. The special generally includes digital compression is done by compressing the video of an image for each frame, and also by removing redundancy data in the same frame. The temporary generally utilizes or uses similarity of sequential frames over the time to change from frame to frame. This is also done by removing the similarities between the successive video frames. So these are the assignments. So basically discuss the effect called as interlacing, discuss different file formats of a video, and is digital compression technique useful for video capturing and reproduction. So these are the references for you, so that you can solve the assignments by visiting the sites and by analyzing the data in the books. Thank you for watching the video.